Hey guys, what's up? It's your girl, I am the Runs Goddess. In the spirit of Valentine's Day, I thought that I would share a little special memory straight from my heart. Okay, this is kind of like when Harry met Sally, almost like when Carrie met Big, but this is how BG met Mr. BG. Okay, yes. And I asked my husband if it was okay to tell this story because my husband, if you ask him how we met, he will say, we met at the mall. And that is true, but he's leaving out a lot of details. And if you know men, when they tell a story, they leave out a ton of details. When a woman tells a story, she gives you all the details. So I'm going to give you the details of how we met. The way we met was not necessarily the most organic way. We didn't meet at the grocery store or anything like that. Let me get into the story a little bit. It's kind of a long story, but hopefully you got a minute, right? Okay, if you're in a rush, go ahead. Do what you gotta do and then come back when you have a couple minutes, okay? But, yes. Right after I got out of the military, I moved to Atlanta. And I don't have any family or any friends here in Atlanta when I moved here. It was just me by myself. Career-wise, I've been in my career for a long time, so it definitely was not hard for me to find a job. It's never hard for me to find a job. One day I'm going to make a video on how to find a job because I think that's one of the areas that God has given me favor with, but I'll talk about that later. Finding a job, never a problem. Okay, so anyway, found a job, found an apartment, everything was going great. The only thing that I was missing was somebody special in my life. It was lonely being here with no family, no friends, no nobody. Just work home. So one day I was watching Cheaters. I love the show Cheaters. Comes on every Saturday night around 11 o'clock. But yes, I'm watching the show Cheaters. And when you watch shows late at night, some of the not necessarily wow chicka wow wow type commercials come on, but you know those dating commercials, are you lonely, are you all alone in the city, you know those kind of commercials come on. And one came on for this place called Lava Life, which was like a phone, a way to meet people on the phone. It wasn't the internet, close, but it was on the phone. And so, you know, I put a little profile on there. I was just lonely. I know it's pitiful. My husband is embarrassed by this story, but he said it was okay for me to tell it. But yeah, I put a little profile on there. I described myself, what I was looking for, blah, blah, blah. Tell him I was, you know, in the city and, you know, just looking for a friendship and things like that. So I got a hit. So a guy, we talked on the phone a little bit and we said we would meet. You know, in the interest of being safe, we met at a movie theater. Drove my own car, met him at the movie theater. Now, let me get the details straight. I'm 4'11", which means I am petite. I do not like... don't want no short man. I'm sorry, to each his own. You know, I know he has a beautiful heart inside and all that. I know that, but I'm 4'11", and you cannot be shorter than me and be my man. I just, that is a no-go. So, the person drove up, and he had a hatchback. Now, he had already previously described himself as being like 6 foot, blah, 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 you know, built, you know, muscular body, blah, blah. I'm like, oh, okay, I'm in for a real treat. So the person pulls up in a little hatchback car, and as God is my witness, the door opens, and I see no one. The door closes, and then this man, the smaller man, comes out from around the car. I did not even see the man until he was out from around the car. That's how small he was. And I was like, you know, I must have gave him a look. I am the queen of faces. I must have gave him a look like, And the first thing he says, you still want to see the movie? I was like, yeah, why not? Because he knew. And I was like, you lied to me. You told me you were this, and you were really that. Okay, so watched a little movie. After the movie, he wanted to go get something to eat. I was like, I'm good. And then we just went on about our merry way. After that, I was kind of a little bit jaded. I was like, okay, I definitely ain't going to find love on this bad boy, but it'd be cool to meet a friend. I'm going to try it one more time, see if I can find me a friend online. So then another guy gives his description. The guy's like, I'm 5'11". They always say that. 5'11", almost 6 foot, you know, college educated, no kids. I don't smoke. I don't drink. Like all this good stuff. I'm like, yeah. So anyway, so he clicks and we start talking and everything, and he asked to go out. And I was like, no, as in my baby Allen Iverson at that time. So my baby's playing in the playoffs this week. I can't go out until Saturday. And he was like, you like Allen Iverson? I was like, what? They call me the sports diva. And my husband loves sports. He was like, what? You like sports? I was like, yeah, I'm not going out to the game until the playoffs is over. And when we do go out, it can't be on game night. I can't miss AI. Kind of find out his favorite player was AI too. And we just clicked. We talked on the phone like all week. And we were just clicking, clicking, clicking. And the thing to me, I was like, okay, if I meet him and he's fine, you know, there might be something there. And if I meet him and he's not or not my type physically, at least I know I got me a friend. So I was like, it's a win-win. So we went to South DeKalb Mall. I was sitting outside of Macy's, South DeKalb Mall. And, you know, all these guys were walking by. And because the first guy had lied to me about what he looked like, I really wasn't sure what to expect. So when guys were like, shout it, shout it, shout it. Shout it, all this stuff. I was like, please, Lord, don't let none of these dudes be him, you know? So, anyway, you know, I'm like, you know, because I'm waiting for my, you know, my husband to come by. So, this car drives by, and this man with the biggest Kool-Aid smile you ever seen in your life showed all 32. All 32 of them. Like, all, I mean, just, like, looking the whole way, all the way over. And I was like, okay, all right. So, true story. So, my husband, I can see the man get out. The sun is, like, behind him, so he's glowing. And I know some of y'all might be like, that's a little bit too much. To me, it seemed like there was a glow around him. Like, oh, for real. Oh. And I was like, oh. I was like, Lord, please, if you love me, let that right there be him. And he walked up to me, and he was like, Star? And I was like, yes. I was like, yes, 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 I'm Star. How are you? And we clicked, hit it off. I gave him a fake name. Gotta be safe. You know what I'm saying? I did tell him to call me Star. And the fool really did. Eventually, I told him what my real name was. But anywho, that's how we met. So like I said, and he would say, we met at the mall. But he won't say, like, you know, this and this and this. And my husband, he had met a girl before he met me. And it was the summertime. And he said that would have turned him off. He said when she got on, he said the first thing he thought in his mind was, what is that, velvet? She said, the girl had on a velvet dress in the heat. In the heat of the summer. He said she had on a long sleeve velvet dress when she went on a date with him. So it's so funny and it's ironic that the first people that we met, we were both like, but we said we were going to give it one more try. And we did. And it was good that we gave it one more try because we met each other. Now, I'm not going to sit here and suggest that online dating or meeting somebody in a way that we met, which is kind of an inorganic way of meeting someone, is the best way, but it did work for us. I have nothing bad to say about it. I mean, when you see those like eHarmony commercials and you see those commercials, people say they met and they fell in love and they're getting married. I believe those commercials. And one of the reasons is because we got a chance to get to know each other. It wasn't about physical. He didn't know what I looked like. Even though I tried to describe myself to him, he still didn't have a concept of what I looked like. But he liked my personality first. And when he saw me, it was like, the personality plus she looks cute. And it clicked. And the same thing for him. I really liked his personality. He was laid back. I remember we went to Applebee's on Memorial Drive. If you live in the A, you know Memorial Drive, Applebee's on a Friday night. Be jumping, 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 jumping. What? You almost need to pay. You have to pay. You should pay like $20 to get in. You have to pay a cover to get in. Because on the right night, Applebee's on Memorial Drive on a Friday or Saturday night is straight up party time. But for real, I know I'm like random and all over the place, but in the spirit of Valentine's Day, I thought I would tell you guys how I met the love of my life. He is my friend. But for real, my husband he's literally my best friend. She kind of shares that title with my sister. My sister's 11 months older than me. And the two of them, I mean, I just trust them and I love them. And it just really feels good to know the man that I'm married to is my friend. At the end of the day, he's my friend too. And I don't have to worry about, I don't have to be glam for him all the time. We don't have to do fancy things all the time. We could sit back and watch a Miami Heat game in a sweatshirt and no makeup and hair looking like Ooga Booga, and he still loves me. But anywho, I love you guys, and I will see you guys soon. This is just how Harry met Sally, more like how BG met Mr. BG. Deuces.